you've probably seen a few of these video ads. Many of these cosmetic companies tout that they're nearly free of toxic chemicals. But if you haven't seen the controversy already, there's a muddy reality when it comes to the clean beauty movement. Experts say that terms like natural and organic are meaningless and often unregulated. So how clean are these products anyway? We have the facts. Popular clean brands like Gwyneth Paltrow's Goop, Jessica Alba's Honest Company, and Beauty Counter have made highly publicized movements away from synthetic ingredients to natural alternatives. But their strategy has sometimes backfired. Honest Company's natural sunscreen didn't protect skin from burning and led to lawsuits, and its baby wipes were recalled because chemical-free meant full of mold. Still, clean beauty proponents make wide-ranging claims about the dangers of chemical ingredients and the extent to which companies are given free rein to include them in their products. Makeup isn't the only thing left unregulated. Terminology follows no rules either. The terms clean and natural are used interchangeably, like safe, green, and non-toxic. Even though these products claim to be a healthier choice, it's all minimally regulated. While the US Food and Drug Administration oversees cosmetics, these beauty products do not need their pre-approval before going into the market. As a stopgap measure, Personal Care Products Council Trade Group created the Cosmetic Ingredient Review Committee in 1976. Their job is to analyze ingredients through rigorous reviews of current studies. Afterward, the FDA takes the report into consideration. So back to the ingredients. Some of the chemicals are harmful, but toxicologists say it depends on the dose. Much of the focus in recent years has been on preservatives, which helps keep cosmetics safe. Just take a look at this video and see how preservatives play a role in personal care products. Preservatives like formaldehyde releasers can be important. They help prevent the growth of mold or bacteria by slowly releasing small amounts of formaldehyde to kill or prevent bacterial growth over time. The Cosmetic Ingredient Review, an industry-funded review panel, has found formaldehyde-releasing preservatives to be safe in low percentages in cosmetics. And the FDA says there's no evidence of human harm from parabens in cosmetics. Much of the controversy comes when people want a yes or no for all chemicals. But toxicologists say it's really the dose that makes the poison. Critics say self-policing is not enough. Advocacy organizations like the Environmental Working Group and Breast Cancer Prevention Partners run websites focused on clean beauty that supports their mission to change the industry. Kourtney Kardashian visited Capitol Hill last April to advocate new legislation about cosmetics. She represented the Environmental Working Group, which launched the hashtag Beauty Made Better campaign to support better cosmetics safety regulations. As the clean beauty movement continues to grow and more people are deceived on the ingredients they apply to their skin, the potential long-term consequences could mount.